नेक्स्ट इज आर राइट टू कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल रेमेडीज. व्हाट डू मीन बाय रेमेडीज? रेमेडीज मीन सॉल्यूशन ऑफ एनीथिंग, इजंट इट? यस. सो राइट टू कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल रेमेडीज मीन्स बाय यूजिंग दिस राइट एनीबडी कैन सॉल्व देयर इश्यूज और देयर प्रॉब्लम रिलेटेड टू एनीथिंग. ओके, लाइक यू नो दैट वी आर हैविंग 3 कोर्ट्स इन इंडिया, डिस्ट्रिक्ट कोर्ट, हाई कोर्ट एंड सुप्रीम कोर्ट. फर्स्ट यू नीड टू फाइल अ केस इन डिस्ट्रिक्ट कोर्ट. After getting decision from the Supreme Court, your district court, and if you are not satisfied with that decision, so you can file a case in High Court. Okay, but let us assume the decision taken by the High Court is not also not satisfactory. Then what you will do? You will file a case in Supreme Court because it is the apex institution in India. So you are going to file a case in Supreme Court, but the decision taken by the Supreme Court will be the final most. It cannot be happen that if you are not satisfied with the decision of Supreme Court, so you are challenging the decision of Supreme Court also, because there is no such authority or no such institution who can challenge the decision of Supreme Court. Okay, so now let's see how this right works. Each and every person of the person of India is not having knowledge of, you can say, constitutional remedies or knowledge of court. We also don't know that what is the proper procedure of lawyers, what is the proper procedure of courts. So for that, we want some organization, like you are having PIL, Public Interest Litigation. It is an organization or it is an NGO which work for any illiterate or poor person who don't have knowledge of courts. Okay, so that organization file a case on the behalf of that particular person in the court, and they will go through with the complete process on the behalf of that particular person. Okay, so that is PIL, Public Interest Litigation. So if you belong to the poor family, and if you are illiterate person, doesn't mean that you don't have the right to file a case in High Court or in Supreme Court after getting not satisfactory decision from the district court. Okay, so this right says that whether you belongs to the poor family, whether you belongs to the rich family, doesn't matter what financial status do you have, but you are having right of constitutional remedy, because our Indian constitution is providing you the court for satisfactory decision. So this, you can say, these courts are equally for all the citizen. It's not that if any poor and illiterate person are not eligible to take services of these courts. No, it will not applicable. Okay, each and every person of the India, whether they are poor, whether they are illiterate or literate, can use the services of courts, and they can also go through with the complete process of taking satisfactory decision from the courts. Okay, so guys, these were all the fundamental rights which are provided by the ORC constitution to us. I hope all the points are clear to you. Thank you so much for this video.